What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min from Architecture Inspirations. Today I'm going to show you how to quickly convert Sketchup Materials to Vray Materials. Let's get started. When you download a model from 3D Warehouse, the materials that come with it might not look great when it's rendered since it's just Sketchup Materials, but with the new version of Vray, you can easily turn those Sketchup materials into Vray materials. Here's how to do it. The first thing I'm going to do is turn on Vray interactive rendering so I can see the changes in real time. Next, I'll press B to bring up the paint bucket tool, or I can just click on this icon here. Then I'll use this eyedropper tool to sample the paint that I want to change. Now you will see that material selected on the list. With that material selected, now go on to the quick settings tab. Then you can click on this button and you will see a list of different presets that you can use to convert your materials. Since we're looking for a car paint material, I'll just select car paint. Now pay close attention to the frame buffer window because the white solid material will now change into a new material that looks more like car paint. I can even go in here and use the region render tool to make Vray focus on one particular area. There we go, you can see it better now. Let's test it on another material. Make sure you are using the paint bucket tool. Now you can just hold down Alt and left click the material that you want to change. Then you'll see that material selected on the list. Now go to the quick settings tab and change it to the preset that you want. For this black car paint, you can see that it has the default blue flakes, but I don't really like it. So I can go over here and change it to white like so. You can even change the flake densities, scale, size, etc. Just adjust it to your liking. Now I think I'm gonna change the material of the rim as well. I can sample it, then go to quick settings and change it to say a plastic material. Then I can reduce the reflection and glossiness with the sliders here. Alternatively, I can use the materials from the built-in library to replace an existing material in the model, like for these tires. I can first go to the library and find a material that I want to use, like this plastic leather material, and then drag and drop it here to add it to the list. Also remember that you can change the way you see the materials with these buttons here. Now right click that material and select copy, then go to the material that you want to replace and right click it to paste the plastic material here. There you go, it looks better now. And that's all guys, you can repeat those steps to fine tune it even more, but that's the gist of it. I hope you found it useful. Make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed the video and comment down below if you have any requests. Stay inspired guys, and I'll see you next time.